Check one, check two, check
right,
one.
I'm about to hit Peace, family.
Well, you don't want the intro music?
All right, go ahead. Let the intro music rock.
Let's find it. I gotta find it first. Let's
peace,
see.
Peace.
It's your time to get
thank you for
populate.
Being patient.
Right. Get populate. Yeah. Ghost in the shell. We're gonna do Ghost in the Shell.
Much
here's about 3-4 minutes. Let me know when you're ready.
Hey. What up, world? What up, Facebook? What up, Spreaker? What it do though? Here on the freestyle Nia.
Do your time to populate.
I told you I was coming back, right? How much did they charge for
Nah, I'm just looking at my FPS per second. Shit is slow. Flip.
Make it.
And the delay, very delayed. This right here, frames per second, let you know keyframe interval should be about 3. That's why I got all these warnings up. But we online on YouTube, on all the YouTube streams, got me, all that. You see me coming in. So you're going to have to kind of lean into the mic. On the phone, and right here, this is going to pick up. We about to kill the music. That's a 5-minute song. Shouts out to Mr. Deity. Thanks for the soundtrack.
Shouts out to anybody being patient. I told y'all we was going to be in about an hour ago. Glad y'all here. I know y'all was waiting patiently. We're going to blow the roof off tonight. Live. On location.
Monte Cristo.
Monte Cristo. Byzantines.
Where Byzantines used to be, right?
If you don't know, then you probably need to get out more. I'm a little bit of Remy popping. I'm trying to get a new level.
None at all. Y'all got that one going too? What did you show? It show.
I have a big girl fetish like 2 months out of every month.
Are those the cold months?
You got one back right now. I like it when they're sweaty. That little oil under the tip. That's your rap.
Okay. We all got 1 minute. on Mr. Vita up. Thank you. You gonna pile it for us tonight. You got that Giami Journey. You got that Giami Journey. Giami Journey's popping. We gonna kick it like this at your birthday party, Miss Navita. We'll be there.
What up, Julius?
I might even do a show.
I like a compilation.
Somebody just liked the video.
Hey, that's what's up. That's what's up. Yo, I'm in great company right now. I got the privilege of hosting the show tonight. I'm riding out the elder, the big homie. The reason I'm sitting in front of you, he would be humble and say it's because something I did, but I will always pay homage to the big homie, Elder Hatem Giami.
You just gave me a promotion.
Not quite. The young elder.
I got to be approved by the elder council. A lot of y'all don't know about that. I'm going to get the car so we know exactly where we are, so we can tell people where we are.
Should be right back. This sounds like some real Matrix shit, you know. I mean, it's real out here, you know. I definitely concur with that. We can get into that later. Let me introduce y'all first. Now, my name is Quasi Lowe, coming to you live on Giami Journey. We at House of Cigars, formerly known as Monte Cristo, right here on North High Street, Columbus, Ohio. I know we're reaching people across the nation, hopefully around the world. I'm with the young elder, Hatem Giami, my man's, my cousin, my people's nephew, Neff. First.
Wait, we are at the House of Cigars on 1088 North High Street. Anybody want to come out and join us? Come on out. But go ahead. Don't finish.
Thank y'all for being patient. You know, we've been just sitting up here chilling for a little while, just kind of talking about, just going over what it was that we wanted to share with y'all tonight. You know, it's always deep conversation with Brother Hatem and Billy. But tonight, I'm really thinking about how we are control, how we're going to take control of what it, of the movement of the energy that we create, especially in light of what's going on, politics, the economy, all of that hoopla that's going on, is keeping us distracted and focused on whatever else. But ultimately, what I'm under the impression is the most important thing that we need to take hold of is the culture. You know, Hatem really impressed upon me the importance of culture, and I wanted to talk about culture from the perspective of myths and fables. It's something that Hatem does very frequently, daily actually. He talks about fables for grown folks. So I was thinking about culture. Me and my cousin here, we be having conversations. Oh, we having a little bit of technical difficulties on. We streaming live from at least like two or three, maybe even four different services, streaming services, whatever you call it. But yeah, I wanted to talk about the importance of culture, man. And I think that the best way to examine culture, one of the ways that Hatem has been examining cultures over the past months and years, is talking about fables and myths and how important they are to stabilizing the culture. So who better to have in the building to really flush that conversation out than the man himself, Hatem Giami. And that's a piece that we over here working on the technical difficulties, they ain't going too far. They fixing the camera. I think my main audience that I'm trying to reach right now might be seeing some distorted pictures right now. They see what y'all see. If you see something that's not quite working for you, you can call in. You can leave a message. You can communicate with us through several different ways. I'm right here. I got my Facebook pulled up. So anything that you want to share with us, you are a part of the conversation. So I want to hear what you got to say. But we're going to kick the conversation off talking about culture, talking about myths, and talking about fables. One of the biggest myths, fables, whatever, however you want to put it, this might actually offend some people, man. I'm not afraid to offend nobody, but it might not be exactly what a lot of people be wanting to hear when I
say that one of the most important myths that we are all adhering to, what I consider a myth, maybe was a real story, maybe wasn't a real story, maybe happened, maybe didn't happen, was the story of this man, the Christ, Jesus the Christ. The whole biblical story is, by many accounts, something that may or may not have actually happened. So when we're talking about myths, understand that the power of the story is more important than whether or not it was an actual event. That is very much my theory, and that is very much something that I want to communicate. I would love to get some feedback from y'all on what you even think is a myth, whether or not some of these things that we are accepting as fact, as law, as events that actually happen, whether they're myths, whether they're real historical events that actually happen, and even if that shit really even matters, if it really happened or not, can we even just take lessons from shit that we hear, from stories that we hear, and not get lost and whether or not it was something that really happened, whether these were real people or not. Is that a distraction? Is that important? Is that relevant? I don't know. It's a question I have. I got way more questions than answers, you know, so that's why I always turn to the people that have been here longer than myself, who've been asking these questions for more years than I have. So I'm assuming, I'm imagining, that I'm actually very much certain, because I've been having conversations with people like Hatem, with people like Elder Tony Baba West, people like, I don't know, some other names that we, some other people.
I mean, we come from a long legacy, bro. As far as Columbus, we've been exploring this for a while. You got, you know, elders that are around you. But let's go back to your question, because Elder, when you say Baba West, you know, that knocks everything, almost everybody else, out of the picture, because we've been studying this a lot longer than I have. But you brought up an important question about whether it really matters, because a lot of people miss the power of myth because they're looking at the historical relevance. They're looking at whether it's real or not. And the thing that we have to really focus on when we're looking at the culture and we're looking at the myths that form the culture is not whether they are historically relevant, but whether or not the myth inspires a sense of mystery. Because with myth comes that sense of mystery, that sense of wonder that in this modern time a lot of us have lost. So when we start talking about it, shouts out to the God King Darrell, shouts out to Sister Navita, anybody else that's tuning in, we want to make sure we're gonna get all the names. We having problems with the iPhone over here. I don't understand the iPhone technology. But you know, you brought up a good point. Does the historical relevance really matter? When we're talking about the Christ, the whole, you asked about that Christ piece. When we're talking about the Christ piece, does the historical aspect really matter when it comes to us dealing with the whole mythic proportions of what happened with this individual? You know what I'm saying? The story is the most important, and we lose focus on the story by arguing constantly about whether or not it's real.
First, real quick, shout out to Brother Raphael in Rio de Janeiro. I see you like the video, man. Peace, bro. My people's, man. I miss you. I ain't seen you in a minute, man. You showed me now, so much love when I was out there. I'm glad you watched.
Hold on. If he on the internet right now, if he wanted to call in and talk with you, he could get on to you through, if he was to go, hold on, check one, check two. The lines are open. We're opening the lines right now. But he would be able to get on. Those that are international, you can get on the call through uberconference.com/GYEAME Journey. GYEANYAME Journey. And you be able to get on. So we can take international calls, which we usually on our show we usually do. I know y'all not used to seeing me sit back and chill, but the young brothers asked me out. I walked in, they planted one of these on me. They planted some drink on me, and I'm like, yo, it's a blessing that I have young people that want to kick it with me and talk, want to chop shop a little bit.
But nah, I gotta actually stop you right there. And I appreciate that, but it's a blessing for me to have access to somebody who's been in this game, who's been thinking for possibly, is definitely, as long as I've been alive, has been dealing with the type of issues that I've been pondering for the last 20 years, maybe even a little longer, but like in the last 20 years, I've really come into the understanding that these type of issues, these type of questions are central to my being, central to my development. And if I'm not asking these questions, then what the fuck am I doing? And so I actually get access to somebody who's been asking these questions, and access to somebody who's been having access to people who's been asking these questions in the lineage